Hello everyone, it's Mitsurugi here, and you're speaking to her hands. And it's a nail tutorial. And of course, we start off with clean nails. You clean your nails under them, in them, outside, off, everything. Clean them so they're clean and fresh. Alright, the two colors that I'm going to be using, because this tutorial will be a fruit. I'm drawing fruit on my nails, and the base coat is, of course, I don't know, what is this? Beauty Secrets Hardener, and it's a high gloss top coat. And then the bottom base color is actually going to be the Balm, what is this, Boom Booms from Walmart. They have these small little bottles. They're really cute. See how much smaller it is compared to this one? Very small. And I get them because I don't really put fingerbolish on that much, but I might do more if you guys like these tutorials. And of course, we can't forget the pens. I don't use real color for real for when I'm doing the design. I use pens. Now, once we put on the fruit that we're going to be drawing on our nails, you're going to need to put another clear coat on top, because if you don't put the clear coat on top to seal it, it's just going to rub off. No, we don't want our hard work to go down the drain as we're washing our hands after we use the restroom and before we eat. Hopefully you guys are doing that, because if you're not, that's disgusting. But anyways, yes, we're gonna start off with putting on our base coat. Yay. And I'm not going to show all of it. I'm just going to show you simple base coat covering for one finger. And then we're going to move on to the next. So we have our base coat on our colors, and you can tell because it has a shine to it compared to the other ones, which is more of a flat matte color. So now we have a shine and gloss. Once we do that, we're going to take our very pretty light color. It could be silver, pink, yellow, blue, whatever it is. It has to be a very light color, not a dark color, a light color. We're going to take that, and we're going to Alright, so now we have just put on the silver, pretty shiny, like whitish silver color on. We're gonna let our nails dry a little bit so that it will be easy to apply. And of course, the first fruit I'm going to do is going to be, excuse the dottedness of it, but it's going to actually be a, see, I'll do an apple first. So I wanna make sure y'all can see this. Hold on a second. Let it focus. The first one is going to be an apple, and basically, you just draw a circle just like this. You go in a little bit and you come out. And then you put a little circle inside of this. And you just fill it in. Just like so. And it all depends on how you want to fill it in. You can leave it a little bit lighter. And once you do that, you're gonna take your black pen and you're gonna create a stem on it. But not too long. Because if we make it longer, then it's gonna become cherry, right? So you can mix the apple and the cherry together and make, I mean, the apple can become a cherry if you make the stem longer. All right, but I'll show you that too. And then don't forget, you get the green pen and you put a little leaf on it. So we have us a little apple, and see if I can see it. It's kind of upside down. Sorry about that. See, flip it this way. Yeah, that's an apple. Okay, you guys, and I've finally finished the apple, and basically what I did was I did exactly what I had drawn on the paper, but the only difference is I put a little shadow under it so it looks like it's sitting on something. Alright, and then I already put the top gloss coat on it so it can't rub off. Alright, so the next fruit we're gonna do is a banana. Here, we're gonna take orange instead. And we're just gonna swoop it like this. Make a little, I don't know, what is this? What do you call it? Swoop it down and curve it just like a, kind of like a smile, like you're drawing a smile. And then just color it in. Okay? And it doesn't have to be too, you know. It's however you want to do it. Now once we've done that, it just looks like a yellow kind of smile thing right here. We're going to take this thing right here. We're going to outline the banana and put a little line in it so it looks more like a banana. One reason why we outline the banana a little bit more so that it looks more yellowy. And then, of course, we put a little shadow on it so it looks like it's sitting on something. And that is our banana. All right, so for those who can't see very well, I just drew my banana and my shadow on there. And the next fruit that I'm going to do is going to be a strawberry. Yay! I'm going to draw it up for you first. Basically, what you're going to do is you're going to kind of do something that looks like a triangle. And if you can see that. And then we're going to do three little, almost like a half star. Did you see how I did that? Let's see. It's kind of like a half star right there. And then we're going to fill in the strawberry. However you like to fill in the strawberry. I like to kind of partially fill it in. That's kind of how I like to fill it in. And then we're going to take the half star that's at the top right here. We're going to fill that in with green. And then we're going to put a little stem at the top. So now we have us, almost looks like a pepper, but it's not, it's a strawberry. The last thing we're going to do is we're going to put the little black dots, the seeds. So we have our strawberry. And alright, and then is our strawberry, if you can kind of see our strawberry. And yeah. And basically, all you do for grapes is you just draw little circles. Simple. But when you draw the circles, you're going to kind of draw the circles in a triangle. Like that. And then, of course, you know, fruit grows on vine, so it's going to have a little vine that comes out the top. And there is our very... Alright, so I have just finished my my grapes. Let's see if you can see that. And if you see that, we've got some very delicious grapes here. And you can see that I put some black around some of the grapes. That way it could be more defined. You don't have to do every grape on your finger, but doing some will make it look like it's defined. And this is a smaller and more simple one for those who don't want to go all detailed out with this one. All right. And the last but not least is cherries. We all love cherries. And if you remembered how we did the apple, the cherries are no different from the apple. I'll show you how similar they actually are. Okay, how you do the cherries is you just draw two circles. And just like you filled in this one, you're going to fill in the cherries. Then once you do that, you're going to take your stem that's from the apple. But the stem here is black. We're going to use green. Yeah, I can see that's green. And we're going to take the first stem from this cherry and we're going to hook it. All right? Then we're going to take the second cherry and we're going to hook it into the other one.
All right, and then we're gonna make a little line that goes across it. Mm-hmm. All right, so that we have some cherries. All right, these are a little bit different from how I drew them on the paper. I actually like how I drew them on paper better than I drew it on my nail. But yeah, we got cherries, grapes, strawberries, bananas, and an apple. So I hope you guys can use that, and there will be more tutorials, more fun, crazy nail tutorials for those. And don't forget.